Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with Yavi Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I want to thank you to start off with, folks, for sitting down in front of the TV to watch this video. I'm really, really excited today to share with you this 04 Winnebago Adventurer 35U model that has just came in. 46,000 miles. Why am I excited about it? It's on the Workhorse chassis. It has the Allison transmission. It has the large 22.5 tires. Unfortunately, Workhorse has gone out of business with that 8.1 engine because Chevy discontinued it. What a great package we have here. Winnebago has been around for a long, long time, just like the RV Corral here in Eugene, Oregon, with over 25 years at the same location. We're very, very excited to be here and handle the new Winnebagos, brand new and also used ones. Some features with this Winnebago Adventurer that I'll share with you that we can't put on the video. Number one is the crown fiberglass roof up on top. Many other manufacturers use a rubber roof, which is a little bit more of a pain. This unit here has a 10-gallon gas electric hot water heater, and one of the features with the Winnebago is it has motor aid. So in other words, the radiator comes back with hoses, wraps around the hot water heater and goes back through. Number one, it makes it a lot cooler when you're running in the summertime. And secondly, after about 100 miles of driving, we have hot water coming through this system. We don't have to wait for that hot water heater to heat up. The other nice thing that the people have done previously, and that is, I don't know if you can see down here, but they put on the more expensive SureFlow water pump system. So in other words, it's going to pump a lot quicker as far as taking showers, example. We do have an awning on the outside, and it is the automatic one. Over here, I have a portable water fill, which will go into my fresh water tank, which is located right over the frame axle over here. Notice how large this valve is as far as a quick dump system. So in other words, if I want to get that fresh water out, pretty quick I can dump that fresh water out so it's not sitting around. Of course, fiberglass siding, and this is all aluminum frame construction, which obviously you cannot see, but it is, and it's all laminated together for a solid wall. Bedroom slide, we'll go inside in a minute. I'll show you that bedroom and closet coming out. This year we have a heat pump down in the basement. Now that residential heat pump is just like a heat pump at home. It heats and it cools. The thing with the heat pump, it's set for about 36 degrees. If that temperature should drop, then my big 40,000 BTU furnace is going to kick on. That furnace kicks on, it's going to obviously put heat down into my holding tanks. So for cold weather, if you're going to use it up camping when it's snowing, weather's down, it's freezing, you no problem with as long as you've got your furnace going. The awning, the ladder accessory, excuse me, is located in one of the compartments down here, and it attaches. They do that primarily if you're in an RV park somewhere. You don't want a little four-year-old kid coming around here trying to climb up your ladder, so it kind of discourages them from doing that. Back on the driver's side, I have a 5,500 watt Onan Marquee Gold generator. Powers pretty much about everything in the coach. 50 amp service, which is really nice. And of course, I can reduce it down. And then my holding tanks. Again, all up in a cavity area. And folks, I said, this just came in. We haven't cleaned it, we haven't touched it, we haven't put our carpet running down. One of the things I will share with you on the Winnebago, notice I've got a label here. So for example, although this is an 04, if somebody would come and damage this door, I don't need to go to a specialty body shop. I can just go to an average body shop like us, because we do have a body shop. Give my parts manager, Greg, that number, and we can reorder your duplicate of this door. That's throughout. Look at the size of that exhaust pipe. That's what you call a Banks exhaust system. It's a manifold, comes right off the manifold. It helps it run cooler, gives it a little bit more pep, and does increase the fuel mileage a little bit. So on the outside, we have the slide outs, the compartment trays that come out, so I don't have to worry about crawling up underneath that slide out. One of the nice things I like is the driver's door, and the reason being is not only is it very accessible for climbing in and out, safety issue, I have a second door to get out of, I have a power window here, but here's the real nice feature. Here's my slide out button right here. So if I'm really close to a tree or I'm in a park somewhere, I don't have to have two people watching this slide out. I can operate it right here and keep an eye on the things. Really nice feature. Have the large mirrors, heated, remote, and my turn signals are built right into the mirror. So Curtis, with that said, let's go inside and we'll show them the nice floor plan of this Winnebago Adventurer. Now folks, while we're going inside here, I would ask you to grab a pen and a piece of paper, because at the end of this video it's going to pop up with my name, Raymond Moore, my cell phone, my email. So if you need to get a hold of me, you have it right there and you don't have to watch this video again. So there is the dash on the Workhorse chassis. Here is my overdrive, which is, means I have my 5-speed Allison transmission. Another nice feature we have is accessibility underneath the dash. So everything is labeled, all of these wiring labeled, fuses are right accessible. If I have a light bulb go out back here, I don't have to pay somebody 2 hours to tear my dash apart. Over on this side, I have a nice desk where I can put my maps. Just release it, goes right back down. Normally, folks, what I do is I'd take this big clumbersome thing off here. It's just portable, it's just sitting there. So that way you can get in and out. Power driver's seat. And I do have up in the front, obviously, my TV. I do have a switch box, and there is a small inverter to run the TV. This chair here, nice little table, so that chair will swivel around, so I've got a nice area if I want to put my computer. Floor plan wise, this is a power sofa, and so what happens is, this is an ottoman that pulls out, and then it goes back in, obviously, and then this is power. So I can recline it, I can take it all the way down for a bed if I want to. Dinette, really kind of unique because this lifts up, so I'm not sitting on a plywood piece of wood. This actually has coils in the seating, so it's very, very comfortable, and also accessibility to getting underneath for storage items. Winnebago manufactures their own furniture called Stitchcraft out of Forest City, Iowa. Thermopane windows, which is really nice, and windows that open on both ends right here. Got a fantastic fan in the galley, and over here I have the Carousel microwave convection oven. So I don't have an oven down here, but what it does give me is a lot more storage for drawers. Four-door refrigerator, which is very, very nice. This side has the ice maker in it. So let's walk into the bedroom. The bedroom has a really nice closet. Did you notice that? When I open the closet door, the light comes on automatically. It's got a switch right here to turn on and off. That's a really nice feature. The bathroom area, I'm going to let Curtis go around and I'll open the door for him. I have a walk-in shower, china stool, nice sink with some counter space, and another fantastic fan up in the ceiling. So now we're in the bedroom area. I have my second TV. And one thing I really want to point out to you is these windows over here. This goes up and they're a jalousy window. So I can open this window right here. I can open the window on the driver's side and I can get cross ventilation going. These beds are sleep number beds right here where you can control the temperature, which is really nice. They've become very, very popular. They're not inexpensive neither. And Curtis, what I'm going to do is lift the bed up so I can show the folks how that heat pump works. Like I said, it's just like at home, where on this side over here, I have a compartment where I have a residential filter down here. I think you can get them like at Jerry's Building Supply anywhere for about 99 cents. But it makes the air inside here a lot cleaner with that heat pump system. And of course, I have an auxiliary chair that they have down left in here. And again, clothes hamper, very, very well thought of, folks. Have another little closet shelving over here. And my little desk area, I can use it for either a makeup area for the wife, or you can use it for a computer area where I have my phone, 12 volt and 110. Well, folks, I know we've been kind of quick going through this nice coach, but I would love to visit with you. If this is a little bit too big, if you're looking for a diesel, Raymond Moore with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I want to thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you've understood it a little bit. English broke, yeah. Have a great day. Give me a call. Email me. Stop on by. Have a cup of tea. Thank you.